Haha.
Jo.
We back, baby.
Broken heart again. Another lesson learned. Better know your friends. Or as you will get burned.
Shout out to Mary every single
gotta
time.
Gotta count on you. Cause I can't guarantee that I'll be fine.
I'll be fine, man. That's
No more pain,
man. Three points game. Yeah, man.
Come on, man.
We're back. Welcome back to Armchair Gaffers.
Baby.
You are here with myself, Wux, SB, and Scorch, who is in good vibes, energy. The North London Derby didn't end in defeat. There were a lot of positives.
We survived.
But we'll get to that. For those of you who are new here, please make sure you like, share, subscribe, and most importantly, comment on our videos. That's the currency that we like. And for those of you who've been here before, welcome back. You know the vibes. We are not joined by Jess today.
Shock.
He had to step away. But I'm sure he will make his views well known once he gets the chance to. But some people are saying that it's not a coincidence that he's not here when things go Arsenal's way. But I wouldn't say that myself.
He'll be here next week. Watch when they win or something. He'll be here.
Well, they got a big game next week.
Yeah.
Man City.
Don't stop. It does not stop. Where do we want to start, gentlemen? I think the North London Derby is the biggest game of the weekend. But if there is somewhere else you'd like to start, let me know.
I just want
to
say one thing. Pochettino, yeah? You're lucky so far every single week. We've got something else that we want to focus on. Usually something more like prosperous, you get me?
Yeah.
We don't want to start off on the wrong foot. But Poch, my friend.
You're awake.
We can see you. Bleeding in the sand. You know blood in the sand is...
Sometimes you might not be sure what it is. But then after a while, it all becomes very clear.
Yeah. But yes. Advert for the Prem?
Yeah, Rio Ferdinand would call this game an advert for the Prem. Yeah, it's just an advert.
Wow, man.
What are you saying? Super sick or something like that.
Sick, man.
Yeah. Illegal. He'd say something like that. It was a great advert for the Prem, as the North London Derby is. Everyone seems to be in agreement that this is now the premier derby of the Prem. It's the one that everyone looks forward to the most.
Yep.
As a Tottenham fan, I'm the wrong person to ask. It'll be fair. Better for you lot to probably say.
As a neutral, yeah.
Yeah, I think it always throws up drama. You get bangers, you get tackles, red cards, none today. But yeah, I'd say it's usually, yeah, and recently, yeah, good football.
I think most of the other ones, like, there's a lot of passion in the other ones as well, but there's not good football.
Sometimes there's usually a style imbalance as well.
There's usually quality, I'd say, in the Arsenal and Spurs.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, there was some quality on show. The game ended 2-2 at the Emirates. Who will be happier with the draw?
Do you know what? Going into the game, and yeah, going into the game, I would have said Tottenham by far.
Yeah.
But after the first 20, when I looked, no, tell a lie. When I looked at the team sheet, I said.
Which team sheet in particular?
Arsenal's. Because Tottenham are.
No Partey, no Martinelli, no Trossard, no Havertz.
It was more about.
In the starting 11.
It was more about, like, I'll be honest, it wasn't so much about who was missing. Because for me, Martinelli is the main one I look at and think.
Yeah.
Because Martinelli and Pedro Porro.
Yeah.
That is a bad matchup. Uh-huh. But it was more, I looked at the midfield and I just thought, given the strength of Tottenham this season, just what we've seen, obviously it's against lesser opposition, you don't know. But the strength of Tottenham's been our midfield.
Mm-hmm.
And I looked at their midfield, I said, Fabio Vieira.
That's probably the one where if there was a spot where you'd say, oh, Spurs have the advantage, or out of the whole, you'd probably say, yeah, he's probably the weakest link out of the six players who probably...
They've been rating him recently, though, this Fabio Vieira.
I'm not he's sure improved, why. But the bar was low.
I'm not either. He just got a left foot to me.
Because you see, Fabio Vieira, like, he's, I've seen him, he looks like he's got tech, but, like, Papsar, I just feel like he's just going to just
could brush him.
Run over him. Yeah. Just, like, just run over.
I've got something to say on Papsar, but we'll
but, yeah, like, I just looked at the two midfields. I thought... Odegaard, Rice, Vieira, and then I thought Bissouma, Sarr, Maddison, with Adoji and Poro.
Yeah, and it's not a it's not just Bissouma. It is Bissouma with a green arrow, the gold pack.
Yeah.
It's a different kind of Bissouma right now. Yeah, that's
the red, gold, and green edition.
Yes. Yeah. Shout out to everywhere. Raya was in goal, started for Arsenal.
Raya.
Is this settling the debate, or is this just part of rotation that we're going to see done. Loads of games? Is it done?
It's done for Ramsey. I feel sorry for him, man.
SB, just talk into the mic and let them know the situation.
I feel sorry for him, man.
Why do you believe it's done? It's only, two games?
Because I thought, all right, cool. Like, I thought, all right, it's brought him in. Arteta said, yeah, I'm going to rotate. So I thought, all right, that's fine. Like, he's been rotating.
Yeah.
I got two big games at the minute, Champions League, North London Derby.
Then, all right, cool. He played Raya a couple games back to back. I thought, okay. Then I saw an interview with Raya.
Yo.
I haven't seen this.
Yo.
He was like, you know, I'm in the team at the moment, but you know, if Ramsdale wants to get, when he's in the team, he needs to fight, you know, when he's in here, he needs to fight for his place.
Oh.
Bro, Raya, I see the thing.
He was little bro in it.
Bro, he said, he looked with a...
stiff face. Mean mugging. He was mean mugging.
It was like, kind of, it was an element of what he needs to do to get in. And I was thinking...
God, he's a goalkeeping coach now.
Do you remember your way around the building? Yeah.
Crazy.
Yeah. And I know Ramsdale, you see, if Ramsdale was talking like that, people would say, oh, there's a problem there. Like, he's not feeling him. But I'm like, you just got here and you don't, like, these lot ain't even your brethren. Like, I know Nketiah.
There's no in-jokes yet. Yeah.
Yeah, like Nketiah's still, you know what I'm saying? You still got
a new guy.
You know what I'm saying? But yeah, sorry, it's begun.
But yeah. But then I watched today.
Okay, what have you seen?
I saw that he's not tall.
Tall.
Yeah, for a goalkeeper, I feel like, you need to have height.
Yeah, he's not massively imposing, but don't you think that...
How tall is he, like 5'9"?
He looks like a 5'10", and someone told me at work the other day, there's no such thing as 5'10". It's men who are 5'9", who pretend to be taller than they are, and if you're actually 6 foot, you say you're 6 foot and stuff.
I feel like if he was 6'2", he would have caught that ball there from when Tottenham scored that. Was it the first
I didn't notice
ball?
It in play. So you like I heard everyone talking about. I missed it, but obviously I'm a Spurs fan. I'm probably bleeding.
If you had a bit of height to you, you just
simple catch.
Yeah,
but what down. If it was when you're?
But he's obviously going back, and then he's tried to flick it. He's done like a flick back to thing, and it's a bit techy because he hasn't played well today.
But it was the save. He did make the save.
The clawback.
Yeah, the clawback.
But do you know what? More than anything, I saw that and I was like, this is deep, man.
That was a good save.
No, the save was good.
Okay, yeah.
But I was like, this is deep, man.
Ramsdale's reaction, the clapping, OTT. Yeah.
No. I just he's trying to do the right thing as a
trying to look good.
I thought it was for his next club or whatever.
I thought it was a little bit disingenuous, but here we are. Shout out to all the goalkeepers, man. Where do we think the game was?
No, but can I just say sorry?
Yeah, go on, switch.
When he made the save, that was a good save. But I thought this is deep because Ramsdale can do that. Yeah. You've done nothing that Ramsdale
passing a little bit better.
No,
not today.
No. We can lie.
I've seen Ramsdale do some
the
passes
spray out to the fullback.
It's cool, but listen to this. The mechanics of the technique may impress you more, but the functionality of what's going on is the same joint.
It's just different.
It's branding. The same joint. It's the same joint. Because guess what? Ramsdale might make you feel less comfortable because he's got that I've been relegated energy about him. But
Bozo energy.
He's got Bozo energy. But this is the thing. None of us watch Brentford like that. Like, I started taking in Brentford Bear when Tottenham got linked with this guy. And I just saw when he's keeping it local, a little bit off on the edge of my seat a little bit. Like, I don't feel like I'm watching Ederson or Onana.
Or Alisson.
Nah, I'm not really seeing that. Like, I'm not. He's good goalie.
Yeah.
But I'm saying I don't see him being better than, like, maybe he beats Ramsdale at two touch. Like,
I don't football see, golf. I don't see such a mad, like, golfing quality that you needed to have both of them at the same time.
So I saw comments earlier this week saying that Raya is the keeper that they want Ramsdale to be. And if he was available when they bought Ramsdale, they would have got Raya.
That's so fair, though. That's fine. That's totally fine.
Okay. They waited, right, so right. They've now got what they wanted. And we'll see how it plays out.
You know, it is, though. I just think, man, it's trying shit.
Yeah.
Fair. Yeah, where the game was won and lost, Arsenal went ahead. There was a lot of talk about Adoji and Saka.
Ooh.
Saka was getting a lot of the ball. It seemed like they were just intent.
You got a different
on getting the ball take up to Saka. To us. I thought it was a little bit overplayed. Gary Neville was making like a massive deal about it. I think Adoji gave away a couple of, maybe three fouls, I think, in the first half, which is a fair amount.
Three?
Yeah, on Saka. That's calm. You're going to be up against
him. Are you trying to
And he's trying to pin you.
Are you trying to get a red?
First 15 minutes, he was under. Yeah, he was under.
But then he got the yellow card midway through the first half. And I don't think Saka took him to the cleaners like he should have. I think Adoji was kind of calm.
That yellow
I think physically, he matched him. Pace on the outside, matched him. I think for the goal, I don't think he was at fault. I think Brennan Johnson, who in commentary they mentioned, stays high. The time he got back and messed things up because he didn't pass on his runner, which was a little bit of a mistake on his behalf.
You know, at Forest, Brennan.
Yeah, it's different now. And what do we think of like Romero in that goal? I think his contribution was rash again.
Bro, the gene.
Bozo gene.
Tell them about the gene walks, please.
It's something that you are born with. I'm not sure the percentages amongst the community or the society or the human population as a whole, but some of us are born with the Bozo gene. And every now and again, it rears its ugly head. However well you're doing, there's always a reminder that you have this predisposition.
Bro, he stuck out his leg to block it and it's come off his knee.
It's like a knee joint thing. Like, it's like, how did it hit this part? Like, you're seeing this part of the knee, like,
it's picked up speed as well, by the way.
You made it go faster with the deflection.
And yeah, I just thought, yeah, that was rash again.
Sort your legs out. Romero. Like, sort your body shape out that this ball is going to connect with you and bounce away. Not shajum with more pace.
And take off.
He's putting pace on it.
Yeah, the physics was crazy. Yeah, I wouldn't be happy with... And I know it's unfortunate, but I think... it kind of just gave us an insight into Romero. But yeah, Arsenal were massively on top there. But Spurs kind of rallied. What do you think of like Spurs' response? People say Madison played really well in the first half. I weren't too sure myself.
Oh, these are delusional bleeders.
Mm.
Maybe of an England national team persuasion or a straight Tottenham bleed. Because he was bleeding.
I was thinking this is cool. JM10. Big occasion, stepping up now. And I think, yeah, he kind of went under the radar, but then there was...
No, he didn't go under the radar. He was there, and it was risky and meaty.
Not the greatest mix.
Look, it's a thing. People, my thing is, like, I've been taking my time on James Maddison. Yeah, I've seen output. But if we're being honest, in the first half, if he got some output out of the first half, which he ultimately did, it would have been, see like people that question Bruno Fernandes.
Yes.
It would have been a vintage Bruno Fernandes.
Okay. Like, yeah.
Whether I've played good or not.
I'm leaving with
here
some.
There we go. Yeah, here's the fantasy football output. Time. You get me? And it was a bit of that. Like he wasn't playing his usual game. And for me, that's kind of how I judge a player. Like you see if you can do what makes you good against Burnley, I'll rate you here. Because this is for Tottenham. This is what matters. You want to be our vice captain.
Yeah.
Wear our number 10.
Stepping up to that plate.
You want to do all the interviews. This is when I need to see.
Carry it.
I need to see it. And I wasn't seeing it. I was seeing shookness.
Okay. I saw like a lot of the time Rice was very close to him. There was a time where he kept checking his shoulder. And wherever he went, like Declan Rice was like in his shadow, which is annoying, but eventually he managed to step it up a bit. What do we think of like the potential of a Son and Madison partnership? Is there something there? Is there
scary?
Is there some chemistry?
Son up top, on the wing,
No more.
Oh, we're done with it.
No more pain. Song not
left wing no more.
I remember 2 seasons ago when Harry Kane was mucking about, Scorch said,
hey,
Song could play as a nine.
Hey.
He's nine.
And I said, at a time, no chance. Across the whole season.
No.
Today I saw a little signs of what could possibly be Son's future.
He's sports direct.
Very, very direct.
I need to run.
That way.
That way. And I need to score.
Do you know what I like though? With his finishing, you see the quality in his finishing. The second one, yeah. Richarlison's never scored a goal like that in his life. Mm-hmm. He's just,
that one's momentum.
It went.
You don't have to. Yeah. You don't have to put your foot through it. Just put good connection. You're doing your thing.
Ray has just
spread out. I've got a take. People say Saka is the nicest man in football. He's like your little brother.
The troll.
You know him. He goes to church, all this stuff, goes home. It's all about football. He's come all the way through the club. What do we think of his new thing of stealing celebrations? Is it a get your
it's
own
so
thing?
Cold. It's so cold.
It's like the birth of a troll.
It's so muggy.
I love it.
It's muggy.
No, so I've seen
it. It now twice.
It's some England thing that you have.
Yeah. You're trying to get the guys.
I see. I asked. Who was it? I asked. Shout out to Henny. I was like, oh, this villain thing he's doing is meh. Like, obviously, I'm a Tottenham fan.
It's the birth of a supervillain.
But yeah. I was like, yo, this is messed. Like, what you're doing, he's locking it in and laughing at guys. But then, but then he said, do you know what he did?
God.
He said to me, bro, no one really clocks it. He hit up Rashford as well.
Yeah.
I forgot he hit up.
It's the double.
I said, this is a villain arc now.
We started this data to be collected.
Yeah, no, I like it.
A few different examples. Yeah, shout out to fake nice guys. I'm one of them.
Because this is the this one, you know, this is when it becomes badness.
Yeah, like keep going.
Wickedness. Yeah, I like it, man.
Because this whole
on the Saka. Big stages as well. Yeah,
Saka, such a nice kid.
He didn't even score the goal as well. It was an own goal.
Mm. Bros.
he did it after the penalty. What do we think of the penalty? Blatant hand. Oh no, sorry. Yes. Before we move on, Madison for Spurs' goal.
Bun him
in the build up.
Did you see him back?
Get back, gang.
Yeah,
Saka was all alone. There was no coverage from Ben White at that moment. But yeah, Madison, that's where I was like, oh, okay, you're here now. Big stage.
Well, no, because you were talking about the first half. But second half now, I'll be honest, it might be time for me to refer to him as Mazza.
Oh, wow. We're here.
Mazza!
Nicknames.
No, because you know what it is? Look, you had a tough game. Shout out Basuma as well, because his first half at times, it was like, I'm trying to play the way that we've been taught to play, but it's techie. Like,
I'm seeing, like, and we see it with all these teams who want to play out from the back. Keeper, roll it to your centre-back, roll it into your six. I don't think I see people take as much risk as Basuma. He's playing it through channels that you shouldn't even try to. Just play backwards.
The only person
he kept doing it. So I was like, I respect it, man.
By the way, just this kind of zeroes in for us that Sergio Busquets is the god. Because he's got all the stuff that Basuma has going for him. He don't have none of that.
He don't have no physical attributes.
I see him still rocking it to today. Like, it's just jiggy.
He has no physical attributes to get minimal. Past
him. His things are minus. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But yeah, like, Madison though, I thought to myself, you know what? You had two moments today, when you needed to get this right.
Yeah.
Not to say you played like terrible or whatever, but these two moments were gonna be defining for like where we're at even as a club right now. Yeah. And you got them right.
No, it's good, man. It's good when it matters. That's what it's about.
Yes.
Turning up when it matters.
Because he makes me, I'll be honest, he makes me cringe a bit.
There is that little element of that.
Everyone's like, why don't you like him? He plays up to it a bit. Bro, he does all the interviews and he says all the cool stuff. Yeah?
It's good.
All the cool stuff. But listen to this. You're scoring against Burnley and you're scoring against Bournemouth. Me, I will not buy into that. Mm-hmm. Yeah? I'm looking at this guy wearing Harry Kane's old shirt. This guy that's got a box that just got here. I need to see you turn up in days. And you know what? He did. You did. That's all I can ask for,
one,
bro.
1-0 Madison. What do we make of the substitutions at halftime? Declan Rice supposedly gone off with a calf injury. Vieira also made way. And for Havertz to come on, and Jorginho, the ex-Chelsea players. Is the Havertz experiment, is it over? Can we be honest?
No, it's also when that happened, I was there asking fans like, we've got so many injuries and stuff.
Okay.
As a Man United fan,
we're in somewhat of an injury crisis. That's you don't have any sympathy for your
brethren. When we're conceding in the 98th minute at the Emirates,
that's
with Johnny Evans and Maguire, it's all banter's flying and everything. Now you got a couple injuries, but you're £65 million.
Now there's an appeal, £65 million,
£250 a week signings coming onto the pitch.
Your highest paid Jorginho, drain.
Who you lot was rating 5 months ago as smart, great business.
You like Jorginho?
I do.
You do.
And he keeps.
Are you going to start complaining?
These mistakes are becoming a
too frequent for me.
It's a bit thing. Spurs conceded a penalty in today's world. Nothing to moan about. No. Yes. At first, I was like,
it's the whole joint. It's the whole joint.
Just consistency. That's all I want to see.
Fair. I thought at first I was like, but then, to me,
I don't like when stuff like that goes against you. Mm-hmm. You can't complain, because in the season these men are gonna screw it somewhere else, and you'll just keep it moving, bro.
And you'll just say,
we've been so far. Do you know what I've realized this season? You only care about this stuff when you're not playing well, because we've been done over maybe like 3 times by VAR. We should have had 2 mm-hmm. pens. There was one blatant pen last week against Sheffield United. Mm-hmm. He just kicked down Madison. There's nothing complex about it. He just kicked him down. Mm-hmm. But we didn't get the fix. But the reality is when you're playing good, you don't... Like, I wouldn't have thought to myself, the game hinges on that. When in reality, that could make a difference. Yeah,
but you're just like, it's going
to
be okay.
Bro, if that's what you're bringing to the game anyway, bigger problems.
Mm-hmm. Fair. Saka dispatched it, and once again... celebration, but the celebrations were short-lived. Gary Neville did say they might be getting carried away with celebrations, and I think it was 50 or 40 seconds later, Spurs went down the other end and scored in a fashion which I've seen. It almost reminded me, it was reminiscent of Man United scoring that counter-attacking goal in the Champions League, just breakaway entertainment, and Son put them to the sword. One thing I rated today about Son with the captain's armband: celebrations.
Ooh.
Jesus Christ. As a neutral, I was just like,
ooh,
fair play.
Korean
badness.
Vim.
Yeah.
Korean badness.
New flavours. Unbelievable. Loved it. And then he hit him with the... Saka didn't grab that one. Because after that, it was a bit of what I thought was a bit of a pocket job. But people said I was going crazy. In a few groups, people told me I'm going crazy.
I didn't see it that way.
The usual joy, man. But
no, it wasn't a joyous event. Pocket is strong.
Mm-hmm.
Strong.
Has he been in good form this year anyway, really and truly?
Saki?
He's leaving with something.
Somehow, yeah.
He's leaving with an assist or a goal. Well,
but I don't think he's been...
I don't think he's quite at the level that he has been at...
previously.
It's a long old season, though.
And yeah, it's early.
He's going to play every single minute.
Old cliche. It's early, because we know what they're trying to do to him. They're trying to finish him. But yeah, all in all, honours even in the North London derby. London is pink.
I need to shout someone out.
Scorch, please shout out.
Mickey van der Ven.
Van der Ven looked. There was a point where I was like, "You might get consumed by the atmosphere."
No, he was my. He was. These were the things I was worried about. Pedro Porro, because that boy cannot defend.
But he's entertaining.
No, bro, he's Tottenham. He's so Tottenham because he can't defend. But if we keep the ball enough, no one's gonna clock. No one's gonna clock. Any kind of to the back post, Romero is crap in the air. Oh my god, and Pedro Porro pretends he's trying to head the ball. Or he does an even colder one, he tucks in too far, so that's where he's gonna go over his head. But he can get the block.
Yeah.
Cool, sick. So that I was worried about Pedro Porro and Van der Ven, because I was thinking, I saw an interview and someone was talking to him about big games in the Premier League and this and that and the North London, and somewhere along the lines, and I've heard other people do this, he said he's been been to Ajax versus PSV.
Nice.
And I thought,
that's a big game.
This but I'm not sure.
That's like
I'm not sure that that can prep you.
That's not enough.
For playing next to Adoji with Poro and Romero. Like, that's
and
not.
Now you're playing.
Because right now, you see these lot, these green arrows. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But I was worried about him, but he settled himself, man. He just kind of just got through the game. Mm. And the other one who's kind of landed. Like, I feel like, am I going ham in saying this? But has Vicario just landed? He had a shaky Brentford and just said, I got this.
I think it's about right. Because, yeah, we don't hear, and that's what I keep saying, when you don't hear about your keeper, that's what you want.
He made a save. Who was the cross? Yeah, the cross.
The Jesus one.
Oh,
into the,
can
into
I just say, this is why Jesus doesn't get you 15 plus goals.
Yeah, does anyone want to take up a bet with SB this year on the 15 Premier League goals for Gabriel
Jesus?
Run
it again, because he never done it last
year.
Last year,
when he went early and said it, the comments were going crazy. You're a madman. You're a hater, a heretic. And
why has he blazed that one over the bar today?
I think that is
that's the game.
The press was sick,
or the embodiment of him. Jesus.
Yeah, did he nick you off Madison?
Yeah, Madison sleeping. And Madison did say, "Yeah, that's part of
you
the way."
Arsenal fans,
and that's going to happen. But yeah, I think that probably embodies what we're going to get with Jesus cross season.
Saliba,
Rolls Royce, or. Some of the passing was a bit shaky in the
yeah, I don't care.
But no, he's my guy. He has taken the aura stone from Virgil van Dijk.
He done some turn.
The little turn with the study.
Oh, I said he
opened up the pitch. Yeah, man.
In the North London derby, and you know what it was as well. Hybrid. You can do that. You know, in a game, yeah, when everything's going your way, mm-hmm. all your passes are going. It wasn't that. Weren't that kind of game. He hasn't shut up Son from doing it. Weren't that? And he said, hold on, what's the solution? Mad quality, done it. Safe.
Dodgy little outside the foot pass. But no, top player. And yeah, he's definitely taken Van Dijk's powers.
And he's got, and you know what as well? He's got, I don't know if you'd call, it's not, like, pace seems like the wrong word. But he's a bit like a juggernaut when mm-hmm. he gets going.
Mm-hmm. He stamps when he's hunting you down. And yeah, he'll definitely
get
there.
If he gets
there. He's going to get there.
Horrible. But no, great, great game. Great advert for the Prem, in the words of Real Ferdinand. And yeah, points were shared in the North London derby. And Spurs still looking for their first away league win away at Arsenal since 2010. But yeah, Arsenal's injury issues are beginning to stack up. So please spare a thought for Arsenal. Where do we want to go next? Scorch, you have an old friend or probably an acquaintance now. I don't think you are going to want to be aligned with him. His name is Maurizio Pochettino. He's currently overseeing, I'm not sure what to call it. Can we call it a crisis yet? Because Man United didn't call their issues a crisis. But can we call Chelsea's current form a crisis?
What would you say if you had your club's worst start in like 40 years?
I would lean towards saying it's somewhat of a crisis, yeah.
It's a crisis, then. It's a crisis. It's been about four. Yeah. It's been 4 years, they said.
It's a crisis.
It's funny as a Spurs fan as well, because Spurs are flying right. You're flying right now. And if it was like 2 months ago, you said this to Spurs fans, they wouldn't have believed it.
No.
Because they saw Poch go Chelsea, I was thinking, oh, we've got no manager.
Chelsea connected. No.
Chelsea have taken our manager. Mm-hmm.
No, I'm going to keep it 100 with you. When Poch first took the job,
yeah.
I was like, that I got Spurs legends, obviously, and they were like, nah, man. I was saying, bro, like, why am I not upset at him? Because
you've seen him,
bro. We haven't offered him a job. What's the man supposed to do? Just not work for forever? And then, that was me speaking. This is before the season had kicked off. That was me speaking with my head. But then, pre-season and
light twinge,
bro. No. He started saying stuff. He started saying stuff like, for me, Chelsea is like one of the greatest teams.
Let's go.
I said, what? Yeah, I said, hold on, you battle of the bridge.
Sever ties.
Yeah, I said, no. Uh-huh. I said,
no.
No. Last, bro, I said, punch. Mm. Hmm. But I still recognize him as being a good coach that I know he is.
Mm-hmm.
But remember, Dan, I'd always said about the job he done at PSG. Stinky Winky.
Yeah, I was like, what more did you want from him?
Stinky Winky.
Not winning that league that first season was very stinky.
And it was, do you know what it was? It was his inability. Oh.
And Jonathan David, like, come on, bro. Renato Sanchez.
Please. Renato was where I draw the line, man.
They made Renato Nick a move.
Nah,
come on, man.
They made Renato Nick a move.
But yeah, with all of that, I was like, do you know what, though? I still see, like, when you look at Chelsea and you look at the situation, he's got a bunch of young, hungry, impressionable
fly
kids.
Flyboys who are on footballers' fits.
Hungry for bagatelle, I think.
No, that's yeah.
They fill up footballers' fits.
Hungry
shout
for
Sumasan. They are running his page right now.
I don't know if they're hungry for football.
Yeah. But I thought the starvation was there. They fooled me. They fooled me. But then, I thought, no, I don't really. Anyway, fast forward, we're here now, and it's not really form, because when form, five games.
Yeah.
Six games is
crisis
default settings.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. This is you now. Yeah,
but hold on 1 second.
Easiest games.
But we say six games. Extrapolate. And this is not Poch. This is just talking about Chelsea.
As a football club.
Extrapolate just over the year. Yeah. At some point, if they go a calendar year of whatever this is, and flux is, yeah. If they go a calendar year, how do we need to reimagine it?
Is this form or actually the club?
When do we actually go from the era?
Is Chelsea actually underachieving, or are they actually where they're at as a mid-table club?
I saw some analysis and they said, when sixth place beat 14th place, it shouldn't be a story, but it's Chelsea and it's Villa. This is where we are now.
It's minging, man.
Horrible. And as you said, calendar year, they have now failed to score in 13 Premier League matches in 2023, more than any other side. It's the most times they've failed to score in a single year in the league since 1995. I was in one of my WhatsApp groups, as I do. Don't really want to go with the boring narratives. I said, should we shoot Poch some bail? Has he been given a situation which is unfair? He hasn't been there long enough. We know that the directors and the Win Stanleys and all these guys. Is it a bit too soon to be bombing on Poch?
No, it's not.
Where does the buck stop? It stops with him.
When you're playing Levi Colwell, left back.
He is one of the hottest prospects in football.
As a centre back.
No, Walks, when did you see that though? That's what I want to ask.
There were elements of it last year at Brighton alongside
Webster.
One of the coldest players. Yeah.
Webster.
One of the coldest.
Especially Dunk.
Webster.
Webster.
You rate Webster?
Not like
Van Heck.
Okay, I see where you're going.
Right.
Yeah.
Guy standing next to Dunk. Right? Doing good.
Yeah. Because we don't wax lyrical about them.
No.
Why would we do it?
No.
It's just the Chelsea branding.
A little bit.
He forced his way into the Chelsea first 11. And I haven't been impressed with him so far this
season. Did he give away a pen in the under-21s? In that huge...
I can't remember.
I'm sure he done something insane in the final.
I can't remember.
I'm just going off of what I've seen. I've been told a lot of stuff. I see really good passing. But Levi Colwill, left back, that stinks. That stinks. Enzo Fernandez in a 10 role. For me, I've given it some time. I've waited a bit. I've basically watched you for a year. And I'm not gonna hide, but I'm not gonna say like raw output, because on one hand, you can't say Bruno Fernandez plays crap bear, but he gets output. So we can't do that. But Enzo, I'm gonna need something. Because this is your thing. You're
Chris Parson.
Good at football, you're easy on the eye. But all of that has got to somehow amount to something, because
3 points.
As good as you are on the eye, it doesn't really seem to matter.
Yeah, what does that actually
add up to?
Yeah, translate into. So all these passes, crisp passes, punched into the front man or sprayed in behind with detail on it.
Like
what
does it amount to? The way they wax on about it, I don't even see that creativity of like a Pogba or something where it's like...
No, that's crazy. That would be ridiculous.
Like, he hasn't even got that kind of creativity. So when I hear about the passing, it's like, I think Enzo's good at passing.
Yeah, like his technique is
sick. But the level of passing that they put him at is like, he's not Tony Cruz.
He's not there just yet.
He's like, him and Tony Cruz could have a competition if the competition is like pass from here to there.
Dead ball.
But that's not the same thing in as in the match. Can you see the woo, that yeah, one? Yeah, like, yeah, or yeah, like, yeah. Can you like? That's not really what's going
the,
on.
The Jordan Henderson round the corner one.
And then you've got like Caicedo, and it's like people made me feel like I was stupid.
Why?
Because people was saying, so the number was started at 80. I remember when the conversation about Caicedo was around 80. I was saying, is everybody smoking drugs? Like, why is everybody talking like ATMs for Caicedo isn't insane? Yeah. Only because we don't know. I'm not saying he's not going to go on to become that.
Yeah.
But why is everybody cool with this? Like, I ain't got a clue. Yeah. And then so now he's here. I'm not judging him off this handful of games, but I'm not sure for 100. Like, because look, I'm just gonna. This is a really harsh comparison.
Let's go, man.
But Jude Bellingham.
Yeah.
I see. When I look, I see. Oh, not always in like in terms of performance in the game, but if I zoom out,
yeah,
I can see 100 M's, and if I zoom in, I can see. I'm just not sure. And I'm thinking,
that's crazy for 100 million. You should be sure.
There's two but different ways it could go with.
Because you've seen Jude play how many games at Birmingham?
Quite a few. Well, I didn't watch them. I watched them.
Play for England.
Yeah, yeah.
You've seen this.
That's enough now. Yeah.
We've seen Caicedo for Brighton. 1.5 seasons at Brighton.
Yeah.
I thought it was like when I heard the press, I thought, oh, I think Caicedo's good. I thought, yeah, good player.
I think he's wavy.
I've been watching him for like 2 or 3 years in the
season.
Oh, no,
that was
bro.
Bissouma. Yeah. Bissouma and Mwepo and all the
bro, others. You know Mwepo is where Mwepo is where I shout out to Carlos here because he's always been talking about and Mwepo is what made me think to myself, yeah, everyone should slow down. Because not to say like he's on a, like that, but Mwepu came in and was doing things.
The same, like how all these Brighton men are moving now.
You know what I'm saying? I don't know.
Yeah, it's tough.
That's what it's about Poch. I feel sorry for Poch because he's got an under 21 team.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Like, fair.
What can you do?
Injuries.
What can you do with under 21? Some injuries as well.
Sorry.
Captain, skip dog. Who? Some people have argued about.
Chilwell is there.
When your vice captain.
Reece James.
Oh, sorry.
Reece James.
Your vice captain's there. The
captaincy.
And you're playing Cowell out of position, but you're not playing your vice captain.
Is he scared of Cowell?
I feel like is Poch being a bit weird. Like, what's going on there, Poch?
Why is he given? Why did he give Chilwell the armband?
Yeah. Vice.
They are experienced players. They've won stuff now.
Thiago Silva is playing every game.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah. He should get it, but
he'd rather give it to Gallagher. Who
I like. I'm with it.
Listen, yes. I'm not dissing Gallagher. I think he's been one of Chelsea's best players. But what I'm gonna say is, they tried to sell Gallagher to Tottenham, and now he's got the armband. It's a bit weird, isn't it? That's all I'm saying.
Nicholas Jackson.
He missed again.
Not Drogba. He's not the second coming of Drogba.
Do you remember the energy they were giving out in pre-season of...
Let him laugh.
I call him a huff and puff, man.
From Villarreal. Yeah. Even Unai didn't want him.
Mm-hmm. And he was playing on the left at Villarreal. So it's probably not a surprise that he's not
scoring
as much of a marksman as Chelsea would want him
to be.
They're
in the mud, man.
But yeah, it's very tough. And he has now picked up 5 yellow cards. So he's suspended for the big derby against West London rivals Fulham. So now
away from
he
home.
Is missing that Malo Gusto.
Whoops, that's not on.
What?
That's true.
Did their thing last year.
You know what you were saying? I was thinking maybe West Ham.
Nah.
Fullingham.
Yeah, so Fullingham. Jackson's missing. Gusto sent off for a red card, went to VAR, was initially yellow, upgraded to a red, Stonewall red. Reece James is injured.
Stonewall red?
Yeah. Why?
Because if that was Casemiro and United,
he was hovering across the ground.
Ankle and get sent off at United. But I even saw the Rodri. We'll talk about it further on.
We'll get there. But yeah, Reece James injured. Gusto's out now. So the problems just continue. No goal since Carnival.
If you slipping.
It's mad. Yeah. 25th of August was the last time they scored.
Chelsea?
Yeah.
Question.
Only wins against Luton and Wimbledon.
What constant?
They call it a month.
No, they've got one more game to get it done.
goal of the month, women's team.
Yeah, if not, you got to start looking.
No,
at
but the season ain't started.
The U2 ones.
Sam Kerr ain't the even got
it. It's the under 21s. It's the 18s.
Casade.
Yeah.
He got a goal of the month.
It's a loan joint.
Who scored on loan? Who's at Leicester doing a bit?
Do you know what it's not to have a goal of the month? Like, that's one competition that everyone should have. They shouldn't discriminate anyone with a goal of the month.
You can't be cancelling your goal.
I was going to ask you, so if you're a player that's had a bit of an up and down season, what constitutes being back? Say you had a bit of a rocky season last season. You nicked a move, didn't really click. Sterling?
He's back, meant to be. He's meant to be.
Yeah, he played well against West Ham.
What, 10 men?
They lost.
Score?
No, I don't think he did.
Oh, score. No. It was the Luton game.
Luton Friday night.
The Carlin
the extension of the pre-season. But yeah, he missed the chance today. And Scorch, you did say you're not sure if it's a natural fit. Gaffers, let us know if you think Pochettino and Sterling's a natural fit. I'm trying to think of players before where Pochettino has made them excel. Like, got a Son, maybe?
Yeah, look at Son now. Son's Son still rasping there.
Or like an outside winger, what, a Lallana maybe?
Son, Giza that was playing Champions League in Leverkusen.
So we just don't think that it's a natural fit, and it might
not work. Seen I'm a Raheem Sterling guy. Mm-hmm. We've seen the decline in Raheem Sterling. And then you want him to go into a
more.
Team to be a leader and do more.
I saw him take a free kick.
Yeah, hit a woodwork, but good free kick. Doesn't matter. Yeah,
they got Raheem training free kicks now. You think Raheem was at City's ground training free kicks?
How's this
arrive?
How's this happen?
Arrive.
Speaking of declines, let's think about the opposite. Ollie Watkins, Villa, strength to strength, decent little goal. Ollie Watkins, more of the same, or
Not strength to strength.
No,
ain't that his first goal?
Leading the line like an absolute ox that he is.
Not for me. No,
I think Villa's been great that season.
Ups and downs.
I just expect, because I know, I told you guys, I know Unai, man, that's my guy. This is what he's gonna do. He's gonna concentrate on winning the. Is he in conference. The conference? He's gonna concentrate on winning the conference to qualify for the Europa League, and then he can win the Europa League. Yeah. Then when he wins the Europa League, he gets into the Champions League, and the whole purpose is
to drop back down. Yeah, finish third.
You get the better players, Champions League players, and then you drop back down to win the Europa League. That's the plan.
Yeah.
And they had a Conference League game.
Yeah, they had a game, and it's about managing load management. They had a whole week off Chelsea.
What is Poch really doing in that training pitch? Then
he's holding.
He's got a week off every week to plan a team. Surely,
it's tough. Do we think he makes it to Christmas? Because I said. Argentina for Christmas isn't that bad, so I am already thinking it might not work.
What I will say is, guys are very lucky that Nagelsmann has taken the job.
Picked up something, yeah.
Because I was saying, there's two guys I'm looking at, and Nagelsmann is just hovering like a Sith Lord in the background, just rubbing his hands like Birdman, trying to just get in the mix. You get me? But there's no real. Candidates.
Yeah. Fair. Shout out to Todd and the
Todd
group
the consortium. Hopefully they get it right, man.
Could you imagine that if Ukraine didn't happen, this whole thing with Chelsea would have just been.
This wouldn't ever happen.
Roman would have just
new chapters, stuff. Man. Shout out to
shout out to Vladimir.
How they get pimped out by Todd?
Chat.
Whoop that trick. Whoop that trick.
Hate to see it. Things we hate to see also is Man United playing at the minute. No style, no fashion, a lack of desire, passion. But yesterday in the Lancashire battle, United came out on top as we are referred to as Moments and Individual Brilliance FC, SB. I know there's great ways to spend your Saturday night. What did you wish you were doing instead of watching Burnley walk all over Man United?
So much, bro, because I actually gave up. Yeah. I gave up my Saturday night for it.
You had an alternative, Dre.
8 o'clock joint as well, man.
That one pushes. There's nothing else to even.
That ruins everything.
I had a link. Anyways, let me just brush that off. You get me? This is a must-win game. For
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like,
this was season defining.
I did say the first.
If we lose this, I need to see how we've lost this. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then, bro, I just sat there for the first 30 minutes, and I was praying. That the thing answered my message.
I've cancelled my plans.
Because you know what you knew? I'll tell you what you knew.
There was no football.
You knew Burnley weren't scoring.
I knew Burnley weren't scoring. And when I saw our lineup, I thought, how the fuck are we going to score?
That back four, what did you think of that back four when you saw it? How fast did your heart start beating? Because I think I jumped.
You know what it was? It started from the back. I saw the back four. I said, Jesus Christ. We've got Spurs' third choice left back here. He seems to be our best player at the moment. Yeah,
yeah. Yep.
We got Lindelof. Like
he's the guy.
He just cuts through like he's just Christian and like a big Christian. Yeah, yeah. Then we got Jono, big Jono back.
Second debut.
No, I like him.
I said that before. I saw yesterday. I said I'd rather Evans than Maguire all day when we first got him.
Bro, remove the sarcasm and banter. Obviously, it's a great angle for banter. Mm-hmm. But if you just step back a little bit and look at what's there and look at the kind of guys in the... You're telling me that Johnny Evans couldn't give Pau Torres a run for his money in a speed race?
Let's not be silly, yeah. Do you know one thing I clocked yesterday? After the game when they were interviewing him, his calves looked mad. They looked like Jack Grealish. I was thinking, how is this guy still in like mad shape? And it's just probably testament to just the way he handles himself and what he came up with.
He's from a different era. Yeah, like
that's why when I see Johnny Evans, I know what I'm getting.
I said, bro, yeah, this guy's
that's what it is.
I know. Like he might get bun. Uh-huh. He might get ripped because he's what 36, 37 with no pace.
No, but he could have got bun in his younger days on a not enough speed. What I know
is he can defend.
Yeah,
and he's going to give it his all.
It's an organisation thing.
There's a minimum level of quality that you're going to receive.
So yeah,
and that was on show.
That was on show.
But then that pass.
I got to the midfield walks. I saw Hannibal. I'm at Tomini.
Speak to me because I've been seeing a lot of stuff of people saying Hannibal cooking.
We're so bad right now that if you just show effort. In a Man United shirt.
Yes, I've been there.
It gets championed.
I'll be honest. When all was said and done after the 94 minutes or whatever, I said, that's a great performance.
No, we needed that from him that day. We needed people yesterday.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That Birmingham loan, man.
Just to run yesterday, we needed people that.
Good.
That's what we needed. But you know what I was thinking, like, I know we're fast forwarding it, but I just want to say before I forget. About what Man United look like right now. We look like this is Ten Hag's first season.
Yo.
All over again.
Okay. Finding our feet.
We feel like we're finding our feet again. He's trying to find formation. We've got injuries at the moment, so that's obviously not helping as well. Uh-huh. Rashford's acting like he's on loan. This is his parent club manager now that he's trying to play for now. Like, this is your manager, bro.
Yeah.
He already knows what you can do, Rashford.
It's time. Get back to it.
Just get back to it, bro. It's fine. Like, I know your heart's there for Man United. I just know that you think you're Mbappe, Rashford.
Once you get
into your brain that you're not that level, but you're like two levels below. But
and that's a good,
that's a good level.
Space to be in, bro.
You can make a living.
Once you do that, bro, and you know that, that's when the team were going to thrive. But
there was one yesterday where he should have set Casemiro, I think.
Oh.
Casemiro made a gut-busting run to get upside.
I saw a picture on Twitter of a kid just pointing at the TV of Casemiro. Okay. Like even the six-year-old knows that's the better option to do their rash.
Yeah, a little bit of tunnel vision.
But we needed a dub.
Yeah. But that's where we are. Yeah, get the 3 points, shower up, get back on the coach.
Bro, we got some easy fixtures coming up and hopefully...
Easier,
I should say.
Because they're going to,
Man United. So hopefully we get some players back because I can't see Hannibal and McTominay in that midfield.
No, again. And Amrabat came on yesterday and he ended up playing left back and got skipped past.
I wondered.
He looked.
When he was doing the subs here, I was trying to work out, were they going to change? And then I saw him at left back. I thought, maybe it's like a four that turns into like
when you're attacking, it's a 3-2-5.
And I just see him lick something down.
Yeah, yeah, quickly, man. He was looking a bit heavy.
But what I would like to say to you, Man United fans as well, don't believe the leaks. Don't be on these dumb Luckhurst clickbait guys. Don't be on them because they're trying to break down. They're trying to get us fans to turn against the manager.
Don't do it.
When there's a deeper problem. Than the manager, which yesterday, we all know.
No Onana mistake, no mistakes from the defence. Cash money. Yeah. Great Saturday night.
Yeah, Onana, man. I don't know about Onana. The midweek, exploits. It's all right though, because De Gea does the same thing.
De Gea.
What do we think about the interviews after the game? After you make a big mistake,
like
if you're a fan, do you want to see that?
I respect it.
Not always. No, it's not. It's not something that I don't like.
I don't want to see too much.
I don't want to see you in same my story. Face chatting was.
Something's gone wrong.
Yeah, because what I want to see is you not doing poorness.
So who's not doing interviews? Vicario.
Right, but though, sorry, I got I need to speak. Please. I must speak.
Floor is yours.
Ten Hag.
Okay.
This is why I despise you. This is why I despise you. No, this is why, because you're a crook.
Wow.
He's a crook because he came here selling magic beans, talking about the style of football. And you know what he's doing? He's doing a lot of things that I've seen other people get sacked at Manchester United for. And you know what you're doing, Ten Hag? You're preserving your role as the manager. So all of the grand plans and it's all a myth. It's all a myth. I've seen Jose get sacked because he's doing the rigid, solid, mm-hmm. Not playing a brand of football that Manchester United like. Yeah. But results. Ten Hag right now is doing get the results. That's where we're at right now. Mm-hmm. Jose got sacked for that. I seen Ole get sacked for not having a clear vision. I see Ten Hag rocking a diamond, doing bizarre things, playing players in bizarre positions, doing different things from what man was doing pre-season, like no clear defined joint. Ten Hag is doing that, it's fine. I seen LVG get the sack because people called the way he was passing the ball around the back boring. No, I know, but I'm just saying these are all things mm-hmm. that I've seen Ten Hag do. And my point is that he just seems like this is why I don't like him. This is why I don't like him even more. It's because he's intelligent enough to read the room and do what he needs to do to survive. But it's all with the zang of a master plan. You've got your players in and I'm not seeing your master plan. Do you know what I'm seeing? I'm seeing a gaffer on the job, going through difficult times, but surviving. And there is no master plan. I don't see man getting any step closer. Even if everybody was fit, mm-hmm. Mason Mount was here, Anthony was available. If Varane was here, I don't see like a thing that I can't imagine what that would look like and that being good. Don't get me wrong. I can see Man U winning games because this guy is smart enough to not shoot himself in the foot bare. That's what it is. And then you've got guys like Bruno who've got that moment of magic. Guys like Rashford have got that moment. And now when you insert the young boy that's going to work hard, and if you work hard enough and got enough talent, good things mm-hmm. come, you got Haaland. And I'm just like, this guy is going to rat his way through. And just like SB said, it's going to be just like last season. Like, that's the difference between Man U and Chelsea. People like comparing where Man U are and Chelsea mm-hmm. are. No, Chelsea are in hell and don't know which way upward is. Like, imagine you're drowning in a pool and you don't know which way up is. You're just swimming in any particular direction trying to get there. This guy, you see Ten Hag.
Where's he swimming?
See Ten Hag. He's told everybody he's an Olympic swimmer, yeah? He's jumped in that joint and it's getting a bit techie, but he's going to pull the rope to get out of the water. He's that guy. He's not going to drown, bro.
That's commendable? Should you survive?
No, it's not.
Swim?
No, because my thing is I don't know that guys doing self-preservation need to be the manager of Man U. So maybe it's a thing where he gets to the end of the season. Like, I feel like the thing that's carrying Ten Hag right mm-hmm. now is that there's nobody really better that we can point to do the job. And as well, like, we're going to talk about the Glazers is not why you're playing a diamond, bro. They're not. It's not the Glazers. I'm sorry. The Glazers isn't why you wanted a ball playing goalkeeper and now you retain the ball and there's not much progression through the thirds. The Glazers isn't why you decided you want Mason Mount and now the midfield balance is slightly not clicking. Mm-hmm. Just my opinion anyway. But yeah, I just I don't doubt him. This is the annoying thing. I don't doubt
this
him.
This is crazy.
I don't doubt him because I know this guy. Yeah, he's smart enough to look after himself. He's the same way he threw Sancho under the bus when he was bleeding and it wasn't really making sense. And now, after Sancho's been removed and we can have a look at it and say, "Raw, Ten Hag ball isn't clicking." Mm-hmm. He's smart. He's the worst kind of bad guy, bro. He's a crook, man. I'm telling you. I don't like the guy, bro.
This is that monologue there. Let us know what you think because we've circled the block again on the Ten Hag thing.
Shout out my boy Jess as well.
A week later. Yeah, I do. Wherever he may be.
No, shout out my boy Jess because Jess...
Wherever he may be.
Jess questioned Rashford in his most purple of purple patches. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the things people
that
are saying...
That level of hate there is different, man.
A lot of the things that people are saying about Rashford mm-hmm. and his decision making, they're things that Jess said a long time ago, bro.
Season just started, man.
Yeah.
He's going to find it. He's going to go purple again. Get double digits
green
and
arrows, man.
Hoyland though.
What are you saying? He's a bad something's youth. Gonna click there.
Nah, he's a bad youth, man.
He's just a physical presence. That he's a Viking. I haven't had powerful running. Like when you see them long like strides.
He does this as well. When he goes like,
I think he'll.
He looks like he's got forearm.
He'll end up poaching. Yeah. A 10 goals.
He's rapid as well.
Just off scraps, yeah.
Yeah. Off scraps alone. Yeah. But yeah, man, it's rare that we have any positivity.
Regular injured.
Hammy came off. Hopefully, it's a precaution drop. Yeah, but Ten Hag sneaked this in. Said he played through the illness. If you're listening, if you're woke, you'll understand.
See, Jose was doing all this and used to get called out about it.
The virus. Got him. Called Pogba the virus. Yes, and look at that now. Liverpool picking up speed in Anfield, quietly getting on with business. Salah, an angry Salah. It seems like he's angry. I don't know what about. But he is just ticking along nicely. Szoboszlai settling. McAllister even chipped in today with a bit of an assist. What do we make of Liverpool? Do you think they're gonna run City close, or is it just too much of an ask for that team? Because the defence is still not 100% where I would want it to be if I was Liverpool.
I think they'll be the closest team to City.
Oh, you think they'll overtake Arsenal, yeah?
Yeah, 100%.
100%.
Scorch,
you
I'm not sure. Like, I think it's in a balance.
It's weird, because I've seen a fair bit of Liverpool so far, but I'm still not drawn on, whether they're going to push on. But there's that little bit of fear, I think, when you go to Anfield again, that's that they're just going to get the job done.
When you go Anfield, even if they play whack, they're going to get the 3 points.
Because you see Klopp, like, let's just, come on, man. There's certain things in life you know, man. And we don't know much in the Prem, but
death taxes
and Klopp. Because you know what Klopp can't do? He can't be whack all season. He'll find it. And can I say, like, there's a player that has just been gone. Like, bro, we was talking about all this, buy this player, buy that, Lavia, Caicedo, all this stuff.
Yeah.
And I was saying to you guys, like, this is a diss.
To who? Who should
this
be?
This is a diss.
Who should take annoyance with
Jones is here, bro. Like, Jones
Curtis
is here. Curtis Jones is here, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And look, when he's come in the team, all suddenly the midfield, because you've got midfielders doing midfield stuff. Very simple. Like, you're not doing... McAllister in the what are we doing, man?
Six.
Yeah, like, bro, let's just pattern the thing and be a bit normal with it. Bring in Curtis Jones and look, the balance is just making a lot more sense suddenly. And I thought that was a big disrespect because I've always liked Curtis Jones. Mm-hmm. And last season I thought he was kicking on.
Was it last season that I think he went back into the cold last season?
Yeah, and the then before, and then he came no he came me through yeah, at yeah. the back end though. Like, yeah, bro.
He's back out in the cold a little bit.
I'm liking Curtis Jones, man.
Someone else that got brought back in, Nunes. In the cold.
Talk to me about his...
What a guy.
SB, break down that finish.
Bro.
Not finish.
I don't know if he means anything.
He's everything at once.
So
like,
sick,
he's good,
man.
And bad at the same time.
At the same time. Like, it's crazy, bro.
Got his goal, though.
I can't diss him, man.
Got his goal. And that's what I think he will do. Got his start, got his goal.
Do you know what? Do you know what? Like, he's the most fun thing to watch.
Yeah, she is.
Like, bro, he like you don't know what he's gonna do
mm-hmm.
for better or worse, but he's capable of
Yeah, it could be extremely high end. Like that miss though. Was
the,
nuts.
The miss is crazy.
The miss is nuts. The feet looked a bit weird. Couldn't set his feet right. And yeah, absolutely.
But then remember the goals against, who was it that they...
To the Newcastle one, we came alive.
Bro, don't them finishes are so hard. Do you know how hard that is?
I think like with him, you have to take the bad with the good. There's going to be some weird, unexplainable things. But then at the same time, he'll actually scare defences.
Yeah.
He'll end up running people the other way and will end up with chances and he'll probably take one out of the three.
Somebody like Cody Gakpo, looks at him and thinks he sees everything he needs to see to know that he's better than him. However, after 90 minutes, that boy is coming out with a goal.
It's theory versus practice. It's mad. It's mad.
Crazy.
Still not sure what to make of Gakpo just yet. And Graven Birch got his Anfield bow. At the other end of the table, sorry, not spoken about, the treble winners. What a shame. They won 2-0 at home against Forest. Probably the biggest takeaway from that was Rodri losing his calm after, I think it's 420 professional games, something like that. First record.
What was that about?
Should have been sent off. It was a bit odd.
What was that about? You're winning 2-0. The half has just started, so you've had your oranges and your jelly babies. So
and yeah, Guardiola said to he angry? Is angry. With Rodri for being sent off because he said, the only thing that we could do is kind of shoot ourselves in the foot. And
I told you, man, bro. If you lot have been Marbella, bro, he's like a Spanish Fed, bro. They're just angry for no reason.
God of Savini.
Yeah, like he, God, yeah. He's just angry for no reason. Gripson up Morgan gives away for what?
He now.
There's like, I saw people like, oh, that's not a red card.
Casemiro.
Talking about
shots, Will Hughes.
Casemiro was acting like it was that cartoon when they strangle in the cartoon. I was like, bro.
No, because you know what's funny? You could see the foot because he it was a grab, but because he wanted to let go of the grab, ended up to being a strike.
Mm-hmm.
And that is quite
in the yeah.
And Morgan Gibbs-White felt the impact and said, like, yep, yo, I'm out of it.
I've seen this in Marbella before. Yo,
I'm out, man. Do you know
business
what?
Business as usual for them.
I was with somebody watching the highlights and they said they don't, obviously, that they're not a football fan. Mm-hmm. And they were like, That looks like somebody that thinks that they're better than someone. That's exactly what they said. Why are you trying to? And I thought, I've won it.
Mm.
But I just want to keep saying it, man, because guys keep telling me different, man. And I'm not sure. I'm not like I got Rice and Rodri in a similar zone, and even I think like Stones is better than him in midfield. I think Stones is casually better than Rodri in midfield. I think he passes through the lines real calm. You see, Rodri, he does a lot of passing around the side. I'm going to do, like, he's got like 90 passes and like bare of them are just from one side to the other, like very safe, where Stones passes through people.
Yeah, I'm not there.
And I never want to hear Rodri compared with Sergio Busquets because he doesn't break lines, bro. For 100 passes,
10.
You're pushing it with
he's
10.
Such
SB.
A reliable recycler.
Yeah, yeah. And who does that sound like? That sounds like Declan Rice, not like Sergio Busquets, bro.
I'm not with you on this one, man.
I'm gonna die on a hill, man.
Yeah. I remember when you floated this idea. I think it was towards the end of last season,
bro. Rodri's best attribute is reliability. He's zanging man with a bit of Spanish in there.
It's a shot.
Like,
no. He's
bro,
a shot.
The shot is deep.
Clutch. He's clutch.
No, I'm with
he might
no.
But the most clutch guy.
Who?
Rodri. Like when it gets sticky.
You mean as in today?
Today.
Oh like, yeah. Yes. Today.
Oh cool.
On a today team.
Final. Oh, semi final.
Oh no, but that's Gundogan though, man. How do we get here?
Yeah, well done. But now.
So I'm saying how.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Is him. But yeah, City, the 6 consecutive wins. Good luck to whoever wants to go up against them. And yeah, after that sending off, Rodri will now miss the Man City and Arsenal game at the Emirates. Does this change things or will Calvin Phillips come in and just be calm and nothing will change?
It doesn't change anything. I don't know if Declan Rice will be fit. Martinelli. They miss Martinelli, man.
He's just a crazy.
He's
crazy
kid.
Threat, man.
Random,
just 100 miles.
Crazy runner. Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah. So Rodri misses that, but I can't see loads changing there, especially after what's what.
I don't know though. I don't know. I tell you who I do think. Oh, Doku Max. We had Gucci Max. Now we've got Doku Max.
We needed a replacement.
God, he's greedy and everything.
Why is he running? Like he's just on like 100.
He plays the same. He can play the same intensity on both wings.
Or going inside or outside.
I'm going to drop an 8 and 10 on the right wing. Okay, I'm going to just drop an 8 and 10 on the left wing.
Bro, do you know what he does? His thing isn't like part of what the rest of the team's doing. Mm. It's like the ball can get to him and it's like, right, cool, me and hold on one sec, I'm going to go over here on this island. And then it's like...
hellish. I would hate to play.
God, man. Yeah. When he isolates you.
It's long.
You're on your own.
You're on your own, by yourself, asking for help.
And he ain't even... you see right now, he's just working off ability.
He
hasn't unpacked.
He ain't even landed.
The boxes are still in his yard, like.
What did they say about Pep usually? First season, they don't
download the files, yeah.
He looks at his
wait till he downloads the files.
It's hard drive-y.
Scary.
Phil. Good guy, man. Is it time?
I put him down as my potential player of the year. I cannot believe that strike. That strike yesterday. He's just saying he's heating up or whatever Charlie Slotkin says. Like he's punched that past the keeper.
Also a bum, but yeah. The goal, that goal is bonkers, but Kyle
Set.
Setman, my God. You see Kyle, man ain't clocking. He's in
a better position, by the way.
Who?
Like, I wouldn't be mad if he took a touch and shot, but he's set.
No, for England, he took that down and scored.
Yeah.
But where I'm going with it is he's in that Carver Howe section.
Okay.
Where, look, guys, I've done it now. So, like I'm just going to kind of enjoy this.
But the
problem is, he's been playing with the safety on. So now the safety's off.
We're going to start seeing some interesting.
Bro, he's doing interesting. Things. What the hell? Why is he? He's making that. See, normally that's the decoy run for someone to get
just a little bit more space.
No,
yeah.
He wants it now. And also, when it comes, first time set cushion.
Everything was perfect, man. Unbelievable.
Sheffield are out of here.
Oh,
sorry, Fort Ellis Forest.
Oh, you think? No, no way.
Sheffield United.
Impossible. Out of it, Forest are calm.
Forget what I said.
But Sheffield United are.
We deal with them. Yeah.
They're like 6-7-0 down as we record. Someone who now we think is staying up is Everton. This will be the last game we speak of. DCL's back. Sean Dyche, Remontada, Decore playing out the pitch. Bit of
Decore higher up.
Watford's vibes. Brentford. I'm a big fan of the whole Brentford experience.
Talk to me, man, because you like to talk a lot of stuff. And I said to you, these guys are naive, yeah? And then I accepted Tony's sick, yeah? Tony's sick, all right, cool. Now Tony's not, and you know the other guy that they don't have that I tried to tell guys is sick? I tried to tell guys, Ben Mee sick. Ben Mee is sick.
Cold.
Ben Mee is Ming.
It's a bit,
it's weird.
Weird now with, what's it now? Pinnock and who's the other guy?
Rico Henry's out, by the way, for the season.
Is he?
Yeah.
Oh, that's bad for them, you know.
It's Jansveld.
Yeah, I looked at their team. I thought they lost to Everton. I looked at the team. What's the team? And I looked at the team and I thought, from the front three, I saw Wissa, Wemo, and who's the other brother?
Shada was injured, so they had
Wissa and Wemo, and there's another guy they have up front that's half decent. Anyways, I see the front three. And then after the front three, I looked back. This looks very championship-ish.
Jano,
Hano.
It's not looking great, man. They've had, I think, three games at home and they've drawn all three, probably not scoring loads as well.
I want to buck Brentford real soon.
I'm a worried.
I'm happy to get them without Tony.
Get out of the way now. I'm just keeping an eye on Brentford. Because the heights that they've reached in the last two seasons have been unbelievable. I don't know if you've seen it. Thomas Frank did a thing on M&F.
Yeah, he gave up his plays,
analysis.
Bro. Gave out his
good,
plays.
It's good stuff, man.
He gave up his plays.
He said he opened the playbook.
Yeah, bro. You don't see Lab no NFL coach talking on no.
What are you saying? Didn't impress.
Giving out his tactics.
Walks. Look.
Didn't impress.
I said to you, Thomas Frank. He's one of them guys. He's one of them guys.
Hipster.
He's a hipster, and you know what it is? He's a man that when his thing connects,
he'll let you know.
He lets the world know. And he's gone on he's gone on MNF, and you don't have Ivan Toney anymore. And he said come on Jamie, definitely three people in the box, come on, you know. Like, I said, Tom,
when was you this guy?
Tom, how have you got here? Because you had some results against Arsenal.
Yeah,
and one or two performances here and there. Listen, Tom.
Tom.
Because this is when I realised they're in big, big trouble. But they're not, because the three teams in the three championship teams are going to go home.
Yeah,
so that's the only reason why you're jiggy. Yeah. I realised Brentford no longer are on set pieces.
Okay.
They don't want corners.
They don't
want to cross the ball.
Anymore,
they can't do it, bro.
It's a hard, tough game when you go to the Brentford ground.
They're back to the Brentford where like people go there. You go there to buy like a striker because they play some stuff. When you watch Brentford, they play. I can't remember who they had a gaffer that was these, but they play stuff.
Smith.
Smith there for a while. What, Ben Rama's of the world.
Like, yeah.
Neil Mopay's.
And they're going back into that direction. Like people are talking to me about Yano.
You want Vikings again?
Yeah. Do you know what I want? I want 90% and Christian Eriksen.
And a bit of quality.
Because now we're pretending that Christian Eriksen's here, but he's not here. It's Jano.
It's bad, man. It's bad. I'm just, just keeping an eye on it.
Is it Jano?
That's the ones as Jensen. Well.
I'm not massive. The Norgards are the
team's
world.
That's it. The team's bad, man.
What's that? There was other guy.
Whisser and Wimmel.
No, who's that? There was the guy, man. He was
previously?
Damsgaard.
Shout out, is it Sampdoria? They tried to tell Tottenham that they want £50 million.
Jensen, Jano. You think I'm worried about that coming to Old Trafford?
Keeper
Collins. Who's Collins?
Collins is. No, and
Collins,
you know,
is that the Collins Burnley. From?
He's the one that battles relegation.
Yeah, bro.
No, he's a hot prospect, man. I nearly fell for.
Did you fall?
Yeah, for the propaganda.
Hickey, come on, man.
It's tough. But I'm just keeping an eye on it because I can't see them being worse than what we've seen so far from the three promoted teams. But it's not looking like great times at the G-Tech. And I guess the gaffers here, they're probably saying, Frank, stay off of MNF.
So, wait, by the way, Tarkovsky said...
I'm the man around here.
Oh, these guys.
No me.
He said, what? I've got no opposition today. Watch this.
Doof, doof. It's
doofed up someone in it. I don't even think it was at the back post. And then he doofed up someone else in like, he said, I'm just going to stay up.
Got an assist.
Doofed up someone for Doucouré. Yeah, that was mean.
It's good work, man.
And now people are going to say, do you remember when you lot were all okay with Tarkovsky playing for England? You sick people.
Bring it back the good times. I guess that is it for the weekend review. DCL got his goal. Shout out to him.
What else you got?
No, I'm just wondering, if you look at the table as it stands.
Oh.
Yes. What you got for us?
So, 1-9. 1-9.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's that.
Man City, Tottenham, Liverpool, Arsenal, Brighton, West Ham, Aston Villa, Man United, and Crystal Palace.
Oh.
There or thereabouts, yeah.
And then 2019 and 18. And so that's that. So that's it's three tables.
Yes. Okay.
1-9. Sorting out who's in Europe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then you got 10-18.
Yeah.
And they're just
in no man's land.
Just sorting it out. Yeah. Sorting it out. And then
the three at the bottom.
And then the ones
Sheffield
there.
United, Luton and Burnley. Burnley got their got their point yesterday.
Yeah. Pedro Neto.
Did you see him?
Jesus Christ, treating guys.
That's about three celebrations as well. Did you see any celebrations he's done there?
It's been a while.
Yeah. Pedro Neto, I just need you to stay fit, nick a move, and get out of there because you deserve so much better. I don't even mind if you go to Arsenal, bro.
Get out of there.
Just get out of there, man, because you're my guy, man. But all them other guys, they're gone.
Done.
They're gone. They're gone.
3 points amongst them from 15, 16.
They got 1 point.
Like, bro, you don't even, like, you can, bro, there's, I'm looking and trying to see, because they all got, for me, they all got different problems. So I feel like if Burnley had Luton striker Morris, I think they could win some games.
He scored his 51st league goal, I think.
There's a pen. But I'm saying, like, he's a striker that wants to, like, he takes shots, they hit the post, like, they look, it's, striker stuff's happening.
Yeah.
When I see Burnley, it's like international keep ball. How can we keep this?
In the nicest.
How can we keep, we can keep it here, and we can keep it here, and we can, if we keep it here, we can keep it here. Like, it's just a lot of keeping it, man. Shout out Colioso, though. He is a live wire. But he's got no striker to give it to.
They were missing their guy yesterday.
Like, yeah, he's not.
He's not answering.
Scary for me in the Prem. And then you got Luton, who were just not the level. Like Luton, I look at Luton and I'm unsure if this exact same crop of players were to drop into the champ.
Mm-hmm.
I don't even know what happens.
Yeah,
I don't even know.
It's rough.
Yeah, and then lastly, you got Sheffield United, who just need to bring back Chris Wilder.
Try again,
Chris. And just try again, because he's learned. He would have learned from that. What you don't need is Paul Heckingbottom, because he's given you nothing, with the hope of not much more than nothing.
And the game's just finished. They have lost 8-0 to rampant at Newcastle. Home.
I think he's going to get sacked tomorrow. You know. I think that was
SB,
it.
He's got a goal,
man. Turn up to work in a hoodie.
8-0, that doesn't really look like
just a hoodie all the time.
Players are really fighting for you.
No, that doesn't give you those vibes. No European hangover for Newcastle. I guess that is it. Thank you for watching again. It's been the weekend review. I've been Walks, he's been SB. That's been Scorch. Jess, wherever you may be, brother.
Hiding.
We hope you are well, and we will see you all again very soon. Peace.
Peace.